Hi, I'm Tony Fole. This is the second and last video about the pneumatically powered slotter that I made. I want to go over the changes I made to the control. I added an Arduino for a little bit more control compared to the system that was in the previous video. And there's one or two mechanical bits and pieces I want to show. First of all, we'll have a look at the difference in the operation that the system with the Arduino makes. Here I've got the solenoid valve mount at the top. At the back, I don't know how visible it is the little control, which is comprised of a potentiometer for setting a delay, a relay, and the Arduino. That's all there is to it. The idea behind this is that normally when this comes down and goes back up again, during that cycle, you need to change the feed so that each time you go deeper and deeper into the material. But the problem was, it was so fast that I didn't know whether I was applying the feed on the upstroke, in which case it would have been forcing rubbing on the tool, which isn't very good. With this new system, what happens is, after it's come down and taken a cut, it returns to the top, but it waits there for a certain period. That waiting period is to give me a chance to advance the feed while the tool is well clear of the work, while it's at the top. Now, I've made the system so that dwell period, that waiting period at the top, can be varied between 0 seconds and 2 seconds. I've actually got it set on 1 second for this video, but I found that I could work quite well with it set to about half a second. Let's have a look and I'll zoom in. So we're zoomed in a little bit and see this clearer. Here I've got a scrap piece of aluminium just for testing. It's a triangular shaped tool that I've got for cutting a groove. Okay, well I've got it working as you can see. You see, it comes down fast, cracks quickly, but waits for a second at the top. That's giving me enough time to advance the feed while the tool is well clear of the work. So let's advance the feed. Turn the noise off. I'm taking this out and you can see here the slot that we just made. So let's now turn our attention to the circuit diagram for the control. It's about as simple as it can get. Well, I've got two circuit diagrams here. This first one on the left shows the schematic before I had the Arduino control. So this is when it just cycled continuously. The one on the right shows the one with the Arduino. If you want a copy of these, I suggest that you just pause the video, make a screen print and save it. Okay, so let's have a look at how this works. So here on this first one, I've got a 12 volt supply here. I just use a mobile battery for that. You could use a plug-in wall wart. In orange, we've got the coil of the solenoid valve. There's a diode across it. That's a standard thing to prevent too much arcing on contacts. In parallel with that, I've got the coil of a relay. Now, this is used as a latching relay. Here, we have the micro switch from the top, and here, we have the bottom one. The top one is normally open, the bottom one is normally closed. Now, if we just had that without the relay, what would happen is, as the RAM was at the top, it would shut this switch, it would close this switch, so the RAM would start moving down, but then the switch would open almost straight away, and so the RAM would go up again. So the RAM would just dither about like this at the top of its stroke. what happens with a latching relay is when the RAM's at the top and it closes this contact, as well as powering the solenoid valve, it powers the relay, but its own contacts are then closed. So when this one opens, this is still closed, and so it maintains the current flow through the solenoid valve. And the bottom sensing microswitch is normally closed. So the circuit, the 12 volts comes in through here, it goes through both of the coils, the solenoid valve and the relay, then passes down through the closed relay contacts down through here. When the RAM gets at the bottom, then this bottom relay, which is normally closed, will open. That will remove the power from everything up here. The relay will click out, the solenoid valve will be turned off, so then the air pressure will lift the RAM up. But there's no delay anywhere, it's just up and down at a rate determined by the pneumatic air pressure and the inertia of the system. Let's move on to the Arduino control one. I'm using what's called an Arduino Nano, which is just a very small version of it, much easier to package, but just as capable as the physically bigger ones. We've got the same 12 volt supply. I'm using the same color codes as here. So the orange is the solenoid valve coil. The blue coil and the blue contacts are from a relay. This is a relay mounted on what they call a breakout board, designed to fit with an Arduino. So what happens here, instead of the relay contacts keeping itself energized, the Arduino does that job. So we just have the one set of contacts from the relay in series with the solenoid valve, so that when the Arduino says that we want to go down, operates the relay, closes these contacts, and the current flows through the solenoid valve and forces it down. Now, I'm using the same two microswitches here, but they're just arranged purely as an input into the Arduino. I've got the pin numbers, for anyone that wants to copy this, I've got the pin numbers of the Arduino that I'm using here. You could use other ones, but these numbers are what I've got written into the software. So it's pin number 9 goes to the relay, the other end of ground. With these microswitches, the top one goes to pin number 2, the bottom goes to pin number 3. Now, just simply to save effort, I kept them in their original configuration. That is that the top one is normally open and the bottom one is normally closed. With the Arduino, it could be any which way. It doesn't matter, it's just a question of the programming in the Arduino. So it's very, very simple. We've got the Arduino here. We can feed it with 6 to 12 volts. In fact, I just connect it to the 12 volts here instead of having two supplies. Here we've got a potentiometer, and that's to adjust the time period. Now I've got it set in the program that from one end of the potentiometer to the other, the delay can vary between 0 and 2 seconds. And the center of that comes in on pin A1, analog 1. So what happens here is, it's very simple. When the RAM is in the top position, it closes this switch. That action is detected by the Arduino through what's known as an interrupt. That interrupts everything else it might be doing. So when it's at the top, that closes this, that signals the Arduino that we want to the RAM down, in other words, power this solenoid. So it sends a signal out to the relay, which closes these contacts, current flows straight down through here and operates the solenoid valve. Then when it reaches the bottom, this contact opens, That sends a signal to the Arduino that we want to lift it up. So that then lifts it up, but the Arduino then introduces a time delay before it sends it back down. And that's really all there is to it. Right, now let's look at a couple of mechanical bits that I didn't get round to in the first video. This is just a block that's made to hold the tool. It's bored 13 millimeter up inside and is clamped in place with some grub screws through these drilled and tapped holes here. Let's take this off. It's bolted onto a normal piece it would find on a compound rest. I've just drilled and tapped two additional holes there to take this. That works fine. This is a fairly solid tool holder that I made. Oh, by the way, the tool that I've got in here, you can probably see, is just been resharpened at this end. It was a broken center drill, but it's high speed steel, so it's ideal. The tool goes straight across. It's held in place by these two grub screws, which force it up to the top of this. So it's all ready to take the loads that are applied upwards on the tool. That works fine for most things, but there are some jobs where this just isn't good enough. For instance, like this clutch basket, there's no way where you can just go straight through. If I had something like this, it's only going to get about, I don't know if you can see that, but it'll only get about two-thirds the way through. The way to avoid that is to put the tool at an angle like this. We don't want to put the grub screw straight up underneath then, because it won't be bearing straight against the side. It'll be bearing on it with a slope. You put the angle like this, machine the end of this off at the same angle, and then put the grub screws in at right angles. You've still got a component of the cutting force, which is tender forcing it upwards, but you're supporting it much better. If you like this video or any of the others, please share, subscribe to my channel, and don't forget to click the button to receive updates of any other videos. Thanks for watching.